everyone, welcome to Artful Studio and this is Anuja. Today we are going to draw few patterns of Gond art. While we are making these patterns, I will be talking about the origin and many other things related to the art. Right now, I am taking a paper and I am just making colorful swatches with the brush pen. Gond painting was done long back by the Gondi tribe, and it comes from the Dravidian expression Gond, which means the green mountain. Paintings are done on wall and floor of the local houses, and local colors and material is used to do it, like plant sap, cow dung, charcoal, colored soil, limestone, etc. These paintings were done by Pradhans, who were basically the music and the story tellers. These paintings were the narratives of their folk stories, their beliefs. They often painted gods and goddesses, animals, forests, and symbols which hold a lot of importance to them. Now here we see that Gond painting has a lot of bright colors. I have already made the swatches and I will be using my just simple black pen to draw the lines and patterns. These lines and these patterns are comprised of very simple lines and dots woven very intricately to give the essence of the picture. These are very bright pictures and people believe that they will bring them good fortune. Gondi tribe always believed that everything has a spirit, the nature, animals, humans, and they celebrated everything. Painting a Gond art on the walls with the belief that it will bring good fortune and ward off the evil. Now few patterns we will see here, which are very, very simple, but when we do the painting, it comes out to be very interestingly plotted in a way that our eye glides through the broken lines and the dots, and it looks very beautiful. Now, Pradhans, as we were talking about, Pradhans were the local storytellers. They had their beliefs and they give the pictorial images to the songs and oral histories of those times. They depict Indian tribal life too, elements of flora and fauna and the interdependence of these elements. So whenever we see the pictures of Gond art, we see that there are animals transforming into plants and the plants taking the shape of animals, or the vice versa. This shows the interdependence, and there are few legendary stories that the Pradhans used to convey through that. Now here I am making very simple symbols which are repetitively done. If you have not liked my channel or subscribed it, don't feel bad about it. Right now, you can just subscribe and stay in touch with me. You can also check me on my Instagram account. And here the symbols are from like small circles, bigger circles, wavy lines, small patterns. But the symbols are taken from seeds, water drops, basket weaving, leaf patterns, fish scales. Such simple things are done, but in a very repetitive manner, which gives a beautiful look to the picture. Many of the painters or the artists have developed their own innovative variations of the art. Using a dot was one of them. Gond art is known for its vivid, bright colors and looks very contemporary. The dot pattern is very similar to the Aboriginal art. and here are few leaves which I am using a general gel pen. In those times, people used to take the bamboo sticks or twigs from the plants and use organically obtained material like lampblack and all such things to do the paintings. Those extracts were was mixed with the plant gum and was quite durable. Now these patterns are distinguished. These small patterns are built to give the texture to the skin, feather, leaves, bark, scales and different portions of the picture. So if it is an animal, the leopard will have dots. These are general things, but simple strokes will make it look beautiful. Now here I used the nib also, and I'm doing it with the dotting tool as well. So you can go ahead and find anything that is a little pointy and would give you the desired circles or dots. Now this painting, Gond paintings, were also called Digna or Bheeti Chitra. There are two types. So Digna was done on walls or on the floor, whereas Bheeti Chitra was only done on the walls. The main subject of the paintings was animal, plants, birds, trees, and with bright, high contrasting colors and variety of patterns. This is what makes this art very, very different. The animal life that we see in the Gond art is elephants, peacocks, birds, crabs, lizards, lion, tigers, deer, snake, cow, monkey, horses, fish, etc. And we also see few times, we also see that there is feeding, just the normal routine, animal feeding on another animal. Rarely, but yes, we do also see people who are busy in their routine life picking up fruits from the Mahua tree. Mahua tree was considered to be a very sacred tree for them, as different parts of the tree hold a lot of value. They also considered Mahua tree to be the tree of life. So here are few basic patterns that I am showing. It is there is a lot of variation and repetition as well. These are few examples. This one is one of the leopard, you can say, the print of the leopard skin, and I am using the ink, which is camel waterproof ink and brush now. So I am changing my tools just to give you an idea that if even if you don't have one, you can use it. You can use another thing to do the same work. Contrasting colors, even the lines. Now later on, there were many artists who made their own innovations by adding the shades to the base. So the base, like I painted it blank, like swatches, the same color, solid color. There are few paintings where we will see that it is shaded. The base is shaded and the pattern builds a little 3D effect. There is one more very peculiar thing about the Gond art is we see that in the Gond paintings, the element is painted and without any bodies, which is very different from that of Madhubani style or a Sora painting that we have talked in our channel before. So Gond art just gives importance to the animals, flora, fauna, and no other side beautification All the lines, all the drawings, all the patterns are just inside the picture. It is not like we'll be making the border, decorative border, and then. So Gond art doesn't have any border. That is what makes it very peculiar. They are very bright colors. Now, initially it was painted only on the walls, and now we see it that it is seen on home decor items, on books, on paper, on fabric, and it is very much appreciated in India and abroad too. Now, Pradhan Gonds was a subgroup of Gond community. They used their imagination to illustrate the folk arts and the folk stories. One exceptional painter was Jangar Singh Shyam. He was the Pradhan Gond, and his work is acclaimed. He's like the Gond artist, I would say. He started using the same thing on canvas and paper for his artwork. Gond people believe every element of nature, be it hills, sky, tree, is inhabited with spirits. These paintings have close connection to the spirits of nature. Also, pictures, dreams, narrations, and also imaginative constructs of people. So there is no bar when you are planning to do a painting of your own. You can make your imaginations, you can see animals flying, fishes on trees, lots of other things that are just in our fantasy. So here, I in this swatch, I'm just showing you very simple patterns, all crisscross lines. These you can just use according to your imagination wherever required. But the patterns are very, very simple. We will further do a lot of paintings on Gond art, and then we will get to understand the art form and what variations can be made on a personal level on the art. So this swatch, I'm showing you two different patterns and how with a small variation they look so different. So these are slant lines, and now it's a little wavy line. You may or may not use the contrasting colors. That the color scheme of this painting is very, very different. Some places we see that there is a lot of contrasting colors in the different elements, whereas on the same body of the animal we see very complementary colors, very analogous palette, like light and dark shades of the same color. So the elephant, if it is a gray, it can have shades of dark gray, light gray, black, whereas the other elements around can be really very bright and contrast to it. Now here I'm just doing my dots in a manner that now it started to look in a very different way. It is looking wiggly, and whereas the other part is quite straight. So we can just use this to our own imagination and to get the desired effect. Here I have done few of the swatches. I hope this is very easy for you all. Further, I will meet you in my next video where we will be painting some motifs. I hope you liked it. If not subscribed, I wish you subscribe the channel, and I will see you soon in my next video. Thanks for watching.